Hi, Liz and Carrie, coming to you from Jones Physical Therapy. We're going to do a couple short videos, just kind of quick tidbits of things that we have patients ask us, or even those little things people don't know to ask that we wish all of our patients knew. And today we're going to talk about labor and delivery. You've gone through the pregnancy, you've maybe had some aches and pains there. We're at that point of labor and delivery. Now what?
Yeah, and we get to see you prior to that. So in the clinic, what are we oftentimes communicating with women about? You
When
know,
we're
we're
coming
getting
down
toward,
to the
yeah, we're getting right
wire.
down to the very last minute of it. And you know, there's a couple things right from the top of my head, and Liz and I have talked about this, and one of them is just the idea of what does pushing mean during labor? And you know, oftentimes I think there is this misconception of what push should be, and that might be the straining. And maybe when you're at that phase, you don't even realize that instead of actually lengthening the muscles in that area of your body, of the pelvic floor, you're actually contracting them. And that can lead to maybe some additional perineal body concerns or perineum concerns. And so, as pelvic health physical therapists, you know, our area of expertise is really to come in and teach you what is that sensation like? What does that awareness feel like to gently let go and lengthen those muscles? And of course, you're going to have to use a little bit of oomph, but it shouldn't be where you're straining and causing some other concerns that could develop.
And I think muscle coordination is a great way to describe it because often what I tell women as they're coming into this last home stretch is that when you get to that point of pushing, a lot of times there's that strong urge to have a bowel movement, and a lot of women tend to then tighten because they're really fearful of losing stool during delivery. Right off the bat, here's the deal. You may or may not poop during delivery. It's completely normal and natural if you do. If there's any stool left at the end of that colon, it's going to come out when that little human being comes out. This is not abnormal to your practitioner. They think nothing of it. You will not know if you did or not. Don't even worry about that. Because what happens is people get that urge, they get a little nervous, and then they want to tighten that rectum to stop from losing stool. Well, that's all intertwined with that whole pelvic floor. So essentially, what you have on going on is this holding in at the rectum, the puborectalis, trying to stop while you're also trying to bear down and push that little human being out. So you need those pelvic muscles to actually elongate and lengthen, like Carrie said, to allow that. So we want to work on that coordination.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, with that, it gets back to the idea of what can we be doing as pelvic health therapists to even help prevent maybe potential injury to that region of the body. And you know, the perineal body, if you're not familiar, here's the trusty pelvis that we have. But the perineal body is the space between the vaginal opening and the rectum. And this is the area where there are a lot of muscles that come in and attach. And oftentimes, this is where if you end up having an episiotomy, you get a little bit of even more tearing, or you can have again where you have that cutting into the perineum. And that can lead to further injury and maybe some concerns with pelvic floor muscle function too. So really important, you know, for us to be able to have that conversation with women towards the end of their pregnancy. And of course, for that dialogue to be opened between you and your medical provider as well, whomever that may be that's delivering your little one. And I think to kind of segue into that, another thing that we often end up talking about during those phases that we get to see you towards the end of your pregnancy is the idea of perineal massage. And that's a really good way to kind of prep and prepare the perineum, again, which is here, to help you even gain more awareness and kind of understand what that sensation is like when it comes to that gentle lengthening process that would be quote unquote pushing, right? When it comes to that phase. So perineal massage is a very safe and effective way of helping mobilize those muscles and tissue to maybe again allow them to be more flexible when you're having that birthing process. Now, very, very important for you to communicate with your provider about this, just to make sure that, you know, you're at the proper week of gestation and that they're okay with it, with your particular pregnancy experience. But this is something, again, we as pelvic health therapists can actually help you with and provide education on.
And like she said, that connection from the brain to the body is huge, and that's where it's great for you to work on this on your own. You know, we can guide you through that because there sometimes is a nervousness, a fear, and anxiety coming into labor and delivery. So it's really great when your brain goes, "Oh, wait, I know what this is. I'm familiar with this sensation." And it's interesting how some women at the end of pregnancy, they kind of stay away from that area. For one, we can't see it very well visibly anymore. But there's a lot of changes happening there. So it is really, I think, key. We talk with our pregnant patients a lot to to connect to that space again. And that's mm-hmm. important that we go through that with you too.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, we're just kind of briefly touching base on this, so stay tuned. We're going to talk a lot about, you know, different things that are happening during pregnancy and even in the postpartum phase, and just general pelvic health concerns to begin with. So if you have additional questions or you want to reach out to us, this is why we're here. We really want to get this information out to you guys and have you feel very comfortable and confident reaching out to us. So if you want to hear something specific, please email Jones PT. You know, you can email Liz directly. You can email me directly at jonespt.com, and we will get back to you and figure out what other kind of talks would be very beneficial.
Yes.